my God.
This is kind of a coming out party, isn't it, for Oscar De La Hoya? The biggest arena he's fought in, the biggest crowd, and so far, the biggest ovation.
The pride of California, the pride of the United States, Oscar De La Hoya. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape for tonight's WBO Junior Lightweight Championship fight. The numbers that we will analyze for this evening's bout, and you see De La Hoya a little bit younger. He's got the height and the reach advantage.
And that's important in this fight because for De La Hoya, everything flows off his jab, and the height and reach advantage will help him get that punch in against Campanello.
And the rules by the WBO.
All right, as we take a peek at these, they are almost identical to the IBF. 10-point must system, 3-knockdown rule is in effect, however. That's one difference. No standing 8-count, and you can be saved by the belt in the last round only, and only the referee can stop the bout.
All right, the main event. We are ready now for the introductions, and we send you up to our ring announcer, Michael Buffer.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Bob Arums, Top Rank Incorporated, along with your undisputed, undefeated King of Beers, Budweiser, proud to be your bud, present the featured bout of the evening. This bout is sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission, Chairman Dr. Elias Ghanem, Commissioners Nat Carasalli, Luther Mack, Dr. James Nave, and Crispin Rivera, Executive Director Mark Ratner, three physicians at ringside, Dr. Flip Romanski, Dr. James Wish Game, and Dr. Robert Boyd. The timekeepers are James Cavan and Mike Lachella. This bout is also sanctioned by the World Boxing Organization, President, former light heavyweight champion Jose Torres, WBO supervisor at ringside, Francisco Valcarcel. The three judges scoring this bout on a 10-point must system are Paul Thomas, Chuck Ciampa, and Bill Graham. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the MGM Grand, the world's largest hotel and casino and theme park located right here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Let's get ready to rumble! The WBO Junior Lightweight Championship of the World. When the bell rings, the man in charge of the action, referee, working for the 65th time in a world title bout, Joe Cortez. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the white trunks with red trim and weighing in at 130 pounds. He comes to us from Crotone, Italy. His professional record, 20 victories, 13 KOs. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the number one ranked undefeated contender in the world, Giorgio. Weighing in at 130 pounds. This 1992 Olympic gold medal champion is 12-0 as a professional with 11 KOs. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the pride of East Los Angeles, California, the golden boy, the WBO Junior Lightweight Champion of the World, Oscar De La Hoya.
Give me a good clean fight, shake hands, good luck.
All right, now, Bernstein, a pumped up crowd here for the WBO Junior Lightweight Championship. A lot of people, as you mentioned, coming here to see Oscar De La Hoya, coming out party, if you will.
You know what's interesting about Oscar De La Hoya? He looks almost, I don't want to say distracted, but about as calm as you can be, and I'm telling you, almost distracted.
Trying to throw that right hand, he was holding as well. Yeah, when he walked into the ring, he seemed to be looking at the crowd a lot.
Just very relaxed.
And down he goes from a left hand.
And maybe not focused. That was my point.
outside the ring and inside, and Giorgio Campanella will get him interested real quick. Hey, he's hurt by the right hand. It's not a knockdown, but that right hurt him.
And he's as dry as a bone.
And he's slugging.
Campanella has 6 first-round knockouts.
And jabbing his way in. Let me tell you, this fight will be won by who lands the best left hook. They're both landing them.
And still 2 minutes to go in this first round.
And you're right. Oscar De La Hoya is dry as a bone. He does not look warmed up.
The pro De La Hoya crowd trying to rally behind him.
Well, if Giorgio Campanella needed anything to get over this scene, if he wasn't over it, that knockdown will help him.
Sometimes that bunker mentality, us against the world, just focused in.
Now, De La Hoya is starting to fight the right way, throwing jabs out there, keeping Campanella busy so he can't just hit him. De La Hoya walked in to slug with Campanella and got a shot, didn't he?
Now, there's a right hand that lands.
And it all came because De La Hoya started using his skills, the jab and the combination. That, of course, is the second time he's been down as a pro, but that time he was hurt much more than he was against Narciso Valenzuela. Let me tell you, when Campanella cranks that left hook, Bob, he's got a good one. And that's the punch that hurt De La Hoya. Campanella's not done yet. Believe me, he's going to land some more left hooks. We'll just see how what effect they have.
Still not a lot of snap on that jab from De La Hoya.
But he's using it well as a rangefinder. And you know, and see now, there's something he's got to be careful about though, De La Hoya. He can't throw too many left hooks early in this fight because that will open himself up to Campanella's left hook. You saw Campanella throw it again.
It's a combination. Everything that De La Hoya throws, the crowd will react wildly.
Giorgio Campanella is making a fundamental error here. What he landed to knock De La Hoya out was a left hook. That's the punch he should go back to. He's not putting himself in position to throw that punch. And he's giving De La Hoya a pass here.
Round number one in the books. What a round one as De La Hoya goes back to his corner for some instruction.
Robert Alcazar couldn't be more precise in what he's saying. And there is why he's saying it. De La Hoya stood in front of Giorgio Campanella. And the reason that he wants him to box is because he stood in front of him and he got hit with left hooks. And he got hit with one specific left hook that really hurt him. And he traded left hooks.
And we begin round number two. They touch the gloves. De La Hoya knocked down early in round number one. And as Al, you pointed out, it was the second time in his career that he's gone down in round one.
It is indeed, but and this time, Bob, it was a much more powerful punch. As you look at the numbers in round one, and ironically, Oscar De La Hoya landing more punches before it was all over.
And his trainer, Robert Alcazar, really stepped on the pedal, Al. And between rounds one and two, the things that you had mentioned in round one that Oscar needs to do, play with him a little, box with him a little.
And the movement is important, as is the jab of De La Hoya. And that's what I said in that first round before we heard Robert Alcazar. Look at the difference it makes. When you jab first, you can make those things happen. Now the left hook of Campanella is rendered useless.
Campanella trying to play back a little bit. And it's gone by in round two.
Now, for Giorgio Campanella, we know what De La Hoya needs to do and what he has now started to do effectively. How can Campanella get past that? And that is to bull your way in, be as rough as you need to be, and just start cranking hooks to the body and the head. It's that simple for Campanella. You're not going to outbox Oscar De La Hoya. Don't throw the hook from outside like he's doing. Pull your way in. If you have to rush in head first, Bob,
get inside where you can crank up those hooks.
There's that jab. We saw it in the Olympics. We saw it in his professional career. When De La Hoya finds that, he's tough to beat.
Extreme. He's almost impossible to beat once that punch gets in there. And I'm going to tell you something. I think Oscar De La Hoya was distracted at the beginning of this fight.
I think
his mind wasn't in it.
And now he's starting to score against Campanella, and is Campanella resting on his laurels of that early knockdown? He doesn't seem to be doing anything to get inside. And De La Hoya now with the combination, and Campanella just not fighting back.
Now, for Oscar De La Hoya, there's one pitfall that remains, and that is trading hooks with Campanella. He's got to be careful about doing that, but if he does all this, he'll get back to being in total control of this fight, which he is right now.
And Campanella blocked off a couple of those punches on the inside, but there's the jab to start it all out.
Well, it's obviously a different De La Hoya. When you jab, when you move...
Oh, Campanella, delay reaction. He is hurt, and down he goes.
Now, he was on his knee. I got to tell you, I take a point away from De La Hoya for hitting him when he was on his knee, but they're not going to do it.
So each fighter has been down through the first two rounds. And Campanella still hurt. Can only be saved by the bell in the last round, but Campanella does get up. And his corner is upset, saying he was hit after the bell.
Well, their bigger claim is that he was hit when he was down before. As they talked to Giorgio Campanella in that corner, I think the one thing they are trying to get across to him is he's got to get on the inside. Now there's De La Hoya hitting away. You've got to take a point away for that. That is illegal and it's wrong, and I don't care who it is doing it, whether it's Oscar De La Hoya or anybody. You don't do that. It's wrong, and Joe Cortez was very late in getting in. Here's where they claim he was hit after the bell. I couldn't hear the bell, so I can't honestly say that.
And we begin round three. De La Hoya was knocked down in round number one. Campanella in round two, and De La Hoya continues the barrage.
Now, there is Campanella trying to get the hook in.
A left and right score. Campanella is hurt, and down he goes again.
This is a replay of the Valenzuela fight in which De La Hoya was sent down and came out with a vengeance.
Another combination. Down he goes again, and a white towel comes out from his corner. That's it.
That man, Campanella, provided anxious moments for this man, Oscar De La Hoya, early in the fight. I will be fascinated when we talk to him to find out whether, in fact, his mind was straight when he came in that ring, because he just went in wildly and got nailed by Campanella. But in the long run, Oscar De La Hoya got the job done, didn't he?
Yes, he sure did. The second and third rounds, he was very impressive. But you mentioned it beforehand. He looked distracted. Giorgio Campanella went down twice in that third round, and his corner threw in the towel as referee Joe Cortez came in to take a look. And let's take a look at the knockdowns by Oscar De La Hoya.
So let's look at the first knockdown from a couple of different angles. Oscar De La Hoya landing a good left hook. Now that was the punch which got him in trouble in the first round when he was trading it with Campanella. But at this point, Campanella was very hurt. He had been in trouble the previous round. And the hooks were valuable for De La Hoya, but they came at the end of combinations, and that's why they were safe to throw. And at this point, Campanella was just not able to really defend himself. And from any angle, it's just as bad for Giorgio Campanella, because Oscar De La Hoya throwing combinations, and that's the key, Bob. When he's throwing combinations, he's a very tough man to beat. And finally, at the end of the fight, this was De La Hoya again throwing combinations. His man was rocked, hit him on the top of the head. His corner was already getting ready to throw the towel in. You saw it sneak in there. And for Giorgio Campanella, what started out so brilliantly in his first trip to the United States ends in defeat.
I'm sure the De La Hoya camp has to be happy with the win, but you know Robert Alcazar, his trainer, has to be upset with the way he went about his business in that first round.
Yeah, and I'm going to tell you something else. That's the second time in his career De La Hoya has hit fighters when they're down in a blatant fashion. It usually happens when he's mad. And I'll tell you what, in the future, they may not be so lenient. They may take points away for them. But this is the kind of boxing skill and power that is likely to make him a real contender in a lightweight division and possibly a champion.
Well, he said this would be his final fight at 130 pounds. He retains his WBO Junior Lightweight Championship. There's Giorgio Campanella. He took De La Hoya down in round one, but then he went to school and was taught a lesson by De La Hoya once De La Hoya started using his jab, as you mentioned, Al.
Well, that was the key. He listened to Robert Alcazar. He used the jab. He started to move a little bit more, and that did it.
Here's Michael Buffer.
Still, the undefeated WBO Junior Lightweight Champion of the World, the pride of East L.A., the Golden Boy, Oscar De La Hoya.
38 seconds of round number three. Oscar De La Hoya of East Los Angeles moves his record to 13-0 with his 12th knockout.
For this young man who came here to fight tonight from Italy, let's give him a hand, Giorgio Campanella.
For Campanella, the first loss of his career in 21 professional fights. He had De La Hoya down in round...